so sorry for all the trouble I put you to. It all seems like madness now. I mean, who in their right mind would turn to the Tunburys for help?
Who indeed?
Here, mister, over here. Please, mister, you've got to help us. The village is in danger, and if someone doesn't do something, you should have seen it.
Stop. Take a deep breath and tell me everything, starting with your name.
Sorry, my name's Eirik. When you went up to the Erevavas with Miss Shula, I followed you.
You could have been killed.
Lady Shula told us you lot were great warriors, so I thought I'd be all right if I stayed close, like. But then I lost track of you in the woods, and that's when I saw it.
Saw what?
A great big dripping, drooling monster. Spitting out great spouts of water it was, that were tearing up the ground and cutting down trees.
Spouts of water? I don't recall seeing anything like that in the forest.
Well, I did, and I don't ever want to see it again. You'll get rid of it, won't you?
All right. If this creature is as terrible as you claim, it could well pose a threat to the village. I'll see what I can do.
Thanks, mister. It was over by the swift one that I saw it. Maybe it's still there.
Then that's where I'll start my search. But this time, you're going to stay here. Understood?
I wouldn't go through those gates for 1,000 gil. Not with that thing out there. Good luck, though.
It was near the swift when I saw the monster. You've got to do something.
I heard the tributary can fell an ibex from 100 paces.
And you could too if you put your mind to it. The blessing of the rill flows within you both.
Where was the cairn you saw flickering again? Over by the fish pool.
Aye, that's the one. Would you mind taking a look at it?
It'd be our pleasure.
You might have a white chocobo, but have you ever seen a silver one? They had them in the north, apparently. They were flighty creatures, though, and the old northerners never managed to tame them. Oh, what I wouldn't give to try.
A storm for the ages, that was. The wind carried off half me blimmin' timber. Just flung it across the forest like a stack of toothpicks.
I'm just glad it didn't carry us off.
After witnessing that little fit of Leviathans, I can see why my ancestors were quick to turn to the witch's magics. Had you not been here to calm the beast? We'd all be sleeping with the fishes.
Is that the hunter?
It's you. Nassif Savior.
Are you all right? What happened?
I was tracking an ibex when a great spout of water struck me square in the back. Sent me flying all the way across the clearing.
Did you see what made it?
No. All I heard was a noise. An ear-splitting din.
Might this be the culprit? Leave him to us. You've caused enough trouble. Well, that wasn't too bad. Hardly a threat to the village, but you can't blame the boy for being scared.
You made that look a lot easier than it was.
Do you think that was the beast which attacked you?
That thing? Not a chance. Would have heard it coming a league away. And the blast of water that hit me was beyond anything an Archelon can manage.
Oh. A boy from the village sent me in search of a beast that could conjure such things, but...
That's it. That's the noise I heard. Sounded like it came from the ruins.
I'll go. You head back to Haven and see a healer.
Keep your wits about you, all right? You don't want to end up like me.
What do we have here? Found her. Something's been busy. Whatever this creature is, it's out for blood. But it's not having ours. It's Stay close, Torgor. Where are you? Fingers crossed that's the last of them. Either way, I should let Eirik know the danger has passed. For now, at least.
How many times do we have to tell you? You're not to go out into the woods alone.
But I wasn't alone. You're back.
So? Did you find the fiend that attacked me and young Eirik here?
I did. It won't be troubling you anymore.
Yes! I knew you'd get it.
Only because you warned me of its existence. Not that you should ever have learned of its existence, but all's well that ends well, I suppose.
What was it, anyway?
A manifestation of Leviathan's power. When we visited Wallius in the Surge, he was angry and afraid. The Icon summoned these creatures for his protection. Though why one would be wandering the ruins of Riversmead, I don't know.
Maybe it was looking for his mom. That's where she died, isn't it? The Falls.
The Falls?
Aye. When they took her baby, she threw herself off the top. We go there once a year to pay our respects. The whole village.
An Eggy is a part of its master's spirit, but Wallius wouldn't have been aware of what had happened to his mother, would he?
Well, either way, you did us a favor putting that thing to rest. Us and Wallius. Thank you.
Aye. Thanks, mister.
It was supposed to be me catching the beasts of the forest unawares, not the other way around. Just goes to show, you can never let your guard down.
When I grow up, I want to be a mighty warrior like you. I'm going to train with the sword every day, inside the village walls, like.
So sorry for all the trouble I've caused.
It is good to have him back.